Show with me, your host, Justin Grisdell. Tonight's special guest, scientists who created bulletproof skin using spider silk. Huh? Introducing the man behind the science, Abel Wahab El Gabzuri.
Thank you for having me on the show.
Yeah, no problem. How's your day going?
Pretty good.
Yeah, nice. Well, let's jump right into it. What is this spider silk bulletproof skin we've all been talking about?
Well, as the name implies, spider silk bulletproof skin is human skin that has been grafted with spider silk to produce an organic substance capable of stopping even a bullet from penetrating.
Wow, all this by one man? How'd you do it?
No, it wasn't all me. I had the assistance of Dutch artist Delura Saidi and Forensic Genomics Consortium Netherlands, FGCN for short, as an experiment to see what a mixture of art and science can achieve.
Wow, okay. Okay, art and science. So you're the Einstein and she's the Picasso. So together, you are Leonardo DiCaprio. Oh, I'm Da Vinci. You're Leonardo Da Vinci, right? Okay, yeah. So tell me, why spider silk?
Well, spider silk is made from an extremely complex protein called fibrin. The silk is held together with hydrogen bonding between the proteins.
Hydrogen bonding, okay. But we already have bulletproof vests using Kevlar. Why should we change it?
Well, the special thing about spider silk is that based on its low density, spider silk is stronger than most forms of steel at the same thickness, and its ductility makes it about 3 times as effective as Kevlar.
Oh, wow, okay. So how does it differ from Kevlar? Like, why aren't we using spider silk right now?
Well, inside a bulletproof vest, there are 33 layers of Kevlar, and in our conducted experiments, we only use 4 layers of spider silk.
So why not use 3 times less, so 11 layers?
Well, we don't have technology currently to create 11 layers.
So where did you get all the spider silk necessary to make the skin? It must be a lot, right?
Well, as you may know, spiders are very difficult to build for their silk.
How should I know that?
Is it not common knowledge?
We're not all scientists like you, Abdul Wahab.
Well, back to what I was saying. The FGCN decided to go about it in a different manner. They took the gene that produces the spider silk protein and put it into a female goat's embryo DNA, in hoping that having the goat mutate and produce this protein in its milk. Then they extract the protein and spin it into fibers of non-sticky spider silk, which could be used for the experiment.
Huh, that is interesting. So, you're talking about bulletproof skin, but all I've heard is spiders and goats. Where's the skin come from?
Well, it's a combination of spider silk and human skin cells.
Okay, so how do you combine the two?
Well, that was the easiest part.
Easy, okay.
We simply made a mesh out of spider silk and grew human skin on it on petri dishes. The skin grew around it, making spider silk lined skin. So the bulletproofness comes from the coating around the skin and not the actual skin.
Okay, so tell me, if you put spider silk and human skin, did you just make Spider-Man? Actually, riddle me this. Why don't we have bulletproof humans walking around?
Well, we have no way of effectively applying this technology to real humans. The skin would need to form around a mesh of spider silk, and we have no feasible way of doing that on a full living human.
Yeah. Feasible, spider silk, whatever. If I were to wear this stuff, would I stop a bullet? Get it off our minds now. Would I be bulletproof?
Well, the answer to that is yes. The skin cannot be penetrated, but the impact of a speeding bullet is nothing to laugh at. It will cause enough internal damage to counteract the protection of the unbroken skin. This is more of a proof of concept than the actual application of spider silk technology.
So it's basically useless right now? Are there any possibilities for it right now at this point?
Well, we can use it for in-skin grafting for burn patients. Incorporating regular silk in burn wounds encourages faster healing and less scarring.
So regeneration powers.
Yes.
Well, that's all the time we have. Thank you very much for the interview. It was very nice meeting you. Stay tuned. After the break, we'll have guest speaker Donald Trump talk about building a wall in between two countries. Isn't that absurd? You'd have to be like president to do that. Silly talk. Well, stay tuned.